Greetings, everyone. This is Fred Coulter. Welcome to Church at Home. Church at Home is sponsored by the Christian Biblical Church of God, and we are dedicated to restoring original Christianity for today, understanding the truth of God, understanding the whole Bible, understanding the plan of God, understanding why Jesus Christ came, understanding what salvation is, how God offers it, and how we can have a relationship with God the Father and Jesus Christ. But the world doesn't want to do that. No, the world wants to have their own way. The world wants to have their own world scripture, where then through diversity and harmonious relationships, all religions can come together and understand one another. And this is really quite a thing. And how did all of this get started? Well, in explaining about the International Religious Foundation, which published the world scripture, they say that through this foundation, it was because the original one who started it was so-called Reverend Sung Myung Moon. And here's what he wrote back in 1985. He called on all the religious leaders of the world to come together to discover their common purposes and the bonds of friendship with which to create an alliance of all the world's religions. Quote, "As far as I know, God is not a sectarian." Yes, God is. God is exclusive. He's not obsessed with minor details of doctrine. Yes, he is. Every word of God is true, and not one word will fail. That includes truth, that includes doctrine, that includes salvation, that includes faith, that includes the love of God, that includes loving your neighbor. Continuing now, "We should quickly liberate ourselves from theological conflict which results from blind attachments to doctrines and rituals, instead focus on living communication with God." Well, partly right. See, the devil speaks truth to mislead with false conclusions. I think we need urgently to purify the religious atmosphere into one in which believers can have living faith and every soul can communicate with God. Now that sounds noble, doesn't it? But you have to come to God His way. See, Satan explains all of these things in terms that sound so good. And for those who are tolerant and politically minded, this is wonderful news. Let's read on. "In God's parental heart and His great love, there is no discrimination based on color or nationality." Well, that's semi-true. "There are no barriers between countries, cultures, traditions, east and west, north and south. Today, God is trying to embrace the whole of mankind as His children. Through inner religious dialogue and harmony, we should realize one ideal world peace, which is God's purpose of creation and the common ideal of humankind." And this is the goal that activated the forming of the World Scripture, a comparative anthology of sacred text. What they have done with this is created a Bible for a coming one world religion. Here's what they are aiming for now. "We believe that the spiritual transformation of global culture could arise through a cooperative network that brings into one linked context the highest insights of all religions and coordinates the participation of millions of people." And that's what this world scripture is all about. Let me read a little bit more of some of the context that they have here. Life beyond death in the spiritual world, evil, sin, the human fall, salvation, and the Savior, the religious life. Oh, isn't that fine if we just all have religion? We'll be just fine. See, the problem is they've equated truth with religion. And religion are all of the ways of man under the guidance of Satan the devil. Then they bring up faith and wisdom and worship and offering and sacrifice, self-denial and renunciation, love for others, providence, society, kingdom of heaven. And so they have a plan. Satan's kingdom on earth. And as we have seen, run by the beast and the false prophet. So here in the preface of the Bible, they read, all the great religions of the world revere sacred scriptures. These sacred scriptures contain essential truth. For this reason, the Reverend Sung Nung Moon, the founder of International Religious Foundation, commissioned this World Scripture Project. One purpose is to celebrate and honor the richness and universality of religious truth contained in the world's great scriptures. An additional purpose is to serve the cause of world peace. So they say we must seek a new, holistic model to describe the human religious experience. And what is that going to be? That's going to be worshiping Satan the devil. And this is the vehicle that they are coming out openly to do. Now, we've seen in Revelation 13 how the whole world is going to worship Satan the devil. And a lot of them already do and do not even know it. Do you know what you worship? Like Paul said to the philosophers there, we know what we worship. Yes, we worship God, the true God. Here's how God looks down on the earth. Isaiah 65 and verse 2. I've spread out my hands all the day to a rebellious people who walk in the way that is not good, even after their own thoughts. Yes, every man does what is right in his own eyes. And if it looks good, appeals to the flesh, if it sounds good, and all those kind of things, then do it. That's not what God says. A people who without ceasing provoke me to my face, who sacrifice in gardens and burn incense upon the bricks, a people who sit among the graves and spend the night in the tombs, who eat swine's flesh and the broth of vile things in their vessels, who say, keep to yourself, do not come near me, for I am holier than you. These are a smoke in my nostrils and a fire that burns all the day. So God is going to judge for this. What are they doing with some of these things? Since they include some of the scriptures in here, let's go to Psalm 50. Let's see what God says of this, because this will breed iniquity and sin, and it will form then the core of the persecutors for the final martyrdom of the saints of Jesus Christ. Psalm 50 and verse 16. But to the wicked God says, what right have you to declare my statutes and take up my covenant in your mouth and put it in a book of world scripture? And try and make God's way equal with the demon and satanic religions of this world. Verse 17, yea, you hate to be taught, you cast my words behind you. Oh, yes, we'll take this, but we'll throw this away. Oh, we'll take this, but we'll throw this away. And let's mix it all together in a wonderful world scripture so all the religions can be harmonious together. It won't work. This is not of God. This is of Satan, the devil. Let's come to Jeremiah 23. And let's see how they do this. Let's see how the prophets of Baal do this. Verse 20, the anger of the Lord shall not return until he is executed, until he has performed the purposes of his heart. In the latter days you shall understand it perfectly. I have not sent these prophets. God never sent Sung Mung Yoon. God never sent Bishop Swing. God never sent the Pope. God never sent any of those who are for the ecumenical things in religion. Yet they ran. I've not spoken to them, yet they prophesied. Now God said, if they would have stood in my counsel, caused my people to hear my words, they would have turned them from their evil way and from their evil doings. But they did not do this. God is near at hand. He's not a God far off. But God says in verse 25, I have heard what the prophet said who prophesy lies in my name, saying, I've dreamed, I've dreamed. How long shall this be in the heart of the prophets who prophesy lies, who are prophets of the deceit of their own heart? They scheme to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams, which they teach each one to his neighbor, as his fathers have forgotten my name for Baal. Not something? Not the way that it is? Yes, indeed. What value is there in church services today? Look, the churches are falling apart even more. Let's see what has happened because of these right into Christian churches. In an article here from Barnett.org, major faith shifts evident among whites, blacks, and Hispanics. Well, it fits just about all the same. So here are the six major things they look to. Church attendance has dropped from 48% in 1991 to 39% in 2011. Adult Sunday school attendance has dipped from 23% to 14%. Bible reading has dropped by 5%, sliding from 42% to 37%. Volunteering at a church during a typical week fell by 8%. And the proportion of the unchurched is growing. You see, the problem is they measure things by churched or unchurched rather than truth and conversion, rather than love and faith, rather than a relationship with God. And that's why we have church at home. Now then, among the Hispanics, it has dropped even more. And the reason is a lot of them, when they come to America, they know and understand the sins of the Catholic Church from where they have come. And they know and understand all of the sins of the priesthood and the lies that come from the pulpit and the idolatry that they have. So therefore, when they come to America, church attendance has dropped from 54% to 33%. Adult Sunday school attendance among Hispanics has declined from 28% to 9% because they're tired of the lies that come from the pulpit. Bible reading has plummeted from 55% to 30%. Attending church of 600 or more is much more likely these days among Hispanics. But what do you get out of the big churches? Well, do they teach the Word of God? Do they teach the faith of God? No, they don't. Well, the blacks haven't slid back quite as far as the rest, so it's really a stunning comparison. Also, another thing that is happening is this. The church is failing the youth with cool ministers and entertainment. No, they really need the Word of God. And all of this is breeding and preparing a whole population that is ready to be sucked into this one world religion. It is all there. This is just like years ago when I talked about the financial problems that are happening, that one day it's going to come due, and we're closer to that day now with the events that are happening. Let's read on here. Here's what God says. Verse 28, The prophet who has a dream, let him tell a dream. And that's what all of this one world religion is. It is the imagination and dreams of men under the inspiration and deception of Satan the devil to try and bring in a one world religion. And they have forgotten that it all began back at the Tower of Babel. And they don't read the scriptures which say, God tells us, come out of her, my people, out of this great Babylon. Now notice, compared to that, here's what God demands. Anyone who's a minister, teacher, or preacher using the Bible had better hear and fear and understand this is the requirement of God. And he who has my word, let him speak my word faithfully. What is the chaff to the wheat, says the Lord? Is not my word like a fire, says the Lord, and like a hammer that breaks the rock in pieces? Now, how does God view all of this? How does God view all of these good works of men intending to bring peace, intending to bring a better world, intending to make things better? Well, isn't that the road that is paved to hell? Good intentions, yes. God says, verse 30, therefore, behold, I'm against the prophets who steal my words, each one from his neighbor. And God is against those who cast his law behind them. Now listen, there are so-called Christian denominations who are becoming such a part of this movement that they're even saying that homosexuality is no longer a sin. And with all of these community groups that they have, it's preparing the way for the one world religion. Now let me ask you, what is it that you want? What is your life? Do you want to know the truth about God? Do you want to live by the truth? Do you want to understand the truth? Do you want to know about the true Jesus Christ and who he is, what he's doing, God's plan for salvation? Well, that's why we're here at Church at Home, so that you can begin to seek God in your home, not get wrapped up in the world's religions, not get wrapped up in those movements which then are designed to take you away from God. But Church at Home is designed to help you draw close to God. We have over 185 segments of Church at Home, and we're going to do many, many, many more. Church at Home is designed to bring you the truth of the Word of God as a start, so that you can draw close to God, learn how to study the Bible, learn how to do the things that please Him. Church at Home is designed to help you come to an understanding in your life of repentance and baptism and the receiving of the Holy Spirit. That's what Church at Home is all about. That's why we have books that we send out at no cost, and you need the book, Lord, What Should I Do? That will help you sort out what you need to do in this world, and why you need the Word of God as the very foundation through Jesus Christ for your life. That's what God wants. That's why we're here. Now, we have to also be a warning. Give a warning to what's going on in this world and how this world is coming apart, while it looks like it's coming together. So it's a conundrum, isn't it? Yes, it is. That's why you need to understand the Word of God. Now, we're going to continue on in the various series that we have. And one of the most important ones that we are doing after we get done here with the religious movements of this world is to know who the real Jesus Christ is, and to understand why he did what he did. Now, you remember when we covered that episode with Elijah and the prophets of Baal. What did Elijah do? He let all the prophets of Baal go first, right? Remember that? Well, likewise, God has let all of the false saviors of paganism come forward first in the same manner. So let's read it here in John, the 10th chapter. And let's see that there is one way, one Lord, one truth, one means of salvation through Jesus Christ, and he is the shepherd of the sheep. John 10 and verse 1, truly, truly, I say to you, the one who does not enter the sheepfold through the door, but climbs up some other way, that one is a thief and a robber. And that's exactly what all of these religions are. They are thieves and they are robbers because they do not go with the Word of God. Now, the Protestants used to claim sola scriptura, but not anymore. See, we need to come to Christ his way. But the one who enters through the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the doorkeeper opens, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name and leads them, and he brings the sheep out and goes before them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will never follow a stranger, for they will flee from him because they do not know the voice of strangers. Now notice what Jesus said concerning all these other ways, concerning all these other religions. Verse 8, all who ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep do not hear them. You see, Jesus Christ is our Lord and Master and Savior. And he is the one who leads us to God the Father. And so we can have a relationship with God the Father and Jesus Christ, which the Apostle John calls fellowship. And that's the most important thing that we need in our lives, the fellowship with God the Father and Jesus Christ, so that we can pray to God. We know God. We understand God. We believe God. We know and accept all the Word of God and with the Spirit of God live by it. That separates us from the world. We're not to be of the world because the world is under the power of the evil one. And this coming world religion is a great movement to do that. But here is what John wrote that we need to focus on, and that is our relationship with God. And that is his way. He writes here, eyewitnesses of Jesus Christ, that which was from the beginning, that which we have heard, that which we have seen with our eyes, that which we observe for ourselves, and our hands handled the word of life, and that life was manifested, and we have seen and are bearing witness and are reporting to you the eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested to us. That's why Jesus Christ came, to give them the gospel, to preach the gospel of the kingdom of God, to go into the whole world. And God has made it today. We now have the whole Bible. We now can prove things and understand things that they could not do back during the apostolic age. Now notice verse 3. That which we have seen and heard, we are reporting to you in order that you may have fellowship with us. For the fellowship, indeed our fellowship, is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. Now then, this is the whole goal and purpose of what God wants us to do. Not get along and go along with the things in the world, but to come out of the world. To learn of the way of God, to understand about repentance and baptism and being perfected through Jesus Christ. That's what God wants us to have with this fellowship with the Father and his Son, Jesus Christ. So once again, thank you for inviting me into your home. Follow along with the scriptures. Be sure and download our articles that we have right here on Church at Home. Go to the sermons that we have on cbcg.org and go to the home page of Church at Home and find out how you can receive the Holy Bible in its original order, the faithful version with commentary. So once again, this is Fred Coulter saying, so long, everyone.